He's also an author, a psychotherapist, and has acted as advisor to heads of state and diplomats in the United Nations. He flew specially here from Capitol Hill, Washington, to be with us on this great occasion. So I'd like to come on. First, giving respects to my spiritual master. Today is the anniversary of his disappearance. 17 years ago, he left this planet. Giving respects to His Excellency, our President of South Africa, State of South Africa, and to our many August visitors. I'm being asked today to do something that is really quite not necessary. To introduce and to welcome someone who everyone knows. Not only is he one of the most popular personalities here in South Africa and on the African continent, but he is one of the most popular personalities in the world. I think it's to all of your credit as South Africans that you have produced such a son, such a father, to represent you and represent the world. He is a stalwart advocate of civic, human, and rights that are even based on spiritual coalition cooperation. Not only is he one who is about all races, tribes, working together, but people working together on religious considerations. This is most important in this world order. Today, one of the greatest problems facing the entire world, facing the global community, is problems of sectarianism, problems due to tribalism, racism, genderism, and sectarian religious considerations. The world is literally fragmenting based on such considerations. So it is very important that we have those who are stepping forward to make a major difference in a global mindset. Worldwide, we are basically, beloved, a weapons culture, a culture of weapons and a culture of drugs. The number one business in the entire world is the pharmaceutical and illicit drug business. Second is the weapons culture, weapons, defense. We are basically a society that is polluting or narcotizing ourselves while we are perfecting our ability how to kill more effectively. Therefore, there is a tremendous need for peace and love. There's a tremendous need for more orientations and personalities to lead brigades, to be able to introduce more and more compassion and unity with diversity. We have such a person here today. Worldwide, the world is spending about $15,000 to $20,000 to equip, train, prepare the average soldier, military, or personality, in contrast to about $500 for educating the average child. Therefore, how one spends their money tells you much about their present and about their future. So what is happening that is very, very significant is the need to be able to come together on significant common ground. It is very auspicious that he is with us today. Here we are in the Hare Krishna facility. We are a society that is world known for having people of all different races, all different economical and social positions and backgrounds from all different religions, Hindus, Muslims, Buddhists, and Christians, who worship together. Our founder particularly wanted to see a world that was based on common ground of literally applying loving our neighbor as ourselves in a way that makes results, in a way that makes effectiveness and causes the quality of life to be improved. You here in South Africa are very fortunate because, beloved, you are actually the mothers and the fathers of present-day civilization. As Africans, as Indians, history, sociology, religion, linguistics testifies that you are actually the people carrying the most ancient culture on the particular planet. Therefore, it is important that you reclaim this planet and bring about more communalism. You bring about more natural association, respect of elders, respect of fear of God and love of God. Too much now the world has become bombarded by a culture of defense, a culture of anger, of greed. Every second or so, one person is killing another on this planet. We have seen that this kind of lifestyle is causing everyone to suffer. It's causing insecurities. So today we have chance to give honor to one of those who have come to be amongst us, who is trying to make an actual difference. We want to give our prayers because this stalwart is being asked to do practically an impossible job. Anything he does is going to please some and discourage and disappoint others. But with the mercy and the blessings of God, that which is seemingly impossible can become an established probability and a reality. So today we all give our love and our blessings, and let us all over the world be able to give strength to such a personality. Before I introduce some last point, what is happening in South Africa is going to have a tremendous effect on the entire world. The entire world is getting motivation by how you are making transitions. Many places are considering moving more toward peace because of what they're seeing happening here. If you fail, not only does South Africa fail, but much of the world will lose its inspiration. And if you succeed, you will go down in history as being some of those who have made a difference at a very important time. Very important time, you will go down as those who have helped at a very critical time, precarious time in world history, has helped to make a global mind change. So let us rally behind these stalwart personalities of peace who are coming to be able to do something significant as we enter into this 21st century. Let us stand as we welcome with love and devotion the state president of the South Africa and one of the major leaders of the entire world. Dr. Nelson Mandela.